And of course, you've got each side that can't see, they're just like the other, and they're even operating by the same dubious tactics and utilizing similar approaches, making them identical. Okay, what we really need to do is look at the inordinate control and power the system is gaining and has gained over us. Okay, people are losing the ability to acquire the other side of the argument, whether it's moon hoax, flat earth, 9/11, aliens, it doesn't matter what you believe. Even if you were curious about some of these things and you wanted to debunk them, you couldn't do it. The only thing you would get would be hit pieces, and you don't have any legitimate information on the other side. Okay, the controllers are molding people's perceptions and limiting them to a small box, and it's like, how can you think that you have a well-informed opinion without information of the other side? And that's the point I've been driving at with this censorship, the censorship push, the modern day book burning, if you will. Because if you control the information, you get to control the perceptions and opinions of folks. So not only can they affect the attitudinal changes and behaviors of people through distorting and manipulating facts, but they're effectively usurping the resistance. And I got at that before, where the up-and-coming generations, they're born into the police state, they're born into schools with facial recognition, and born into a world where most, if not all, information is either consolidated, skewed, or buried altogether. So there's little wiggle room available to those trying to reach like-minded people, even outside of the main vein. That's what this push is doing. And that's another reason why we're stepping away from politics, because again, to turn a blind eye or embrace willful ignorance in matters like these, tells me all I need to know. No matter the subject, if folks aren't willing to look at something dispassionately and see the facts objectively, that says the gears just aren't turning. So if we're looking for thoughtful, dispassionate discourse, the political arena is not the field for that, because there's actually more going on in the world than the proverbial Hillary Clintons, Donald Trumps, and Barack Obamas, and their counterparts across the pond. Because if you can imagine that, I think you're better able to dissect some of the more seemingly intangible aspects behind these figures, okay? And you know, while I get that most people try to fit things into that easily understandable box, sometimes some things do go beyond just the five sense level of reality and our nuts and bolts understanding of how the world actually works. And I'll tell you, one of the things that seems to creep up time and again when you research the topics that we broadcast here on California Carter is the realization that there's no way we're just talking about greedy corporations, corrupt bankers, zany politicians, and wealthy families of influence on like that. There's no way, okay? There's forces beyond just humans, beyond just people. So we have to see matters beyond purely human factors and influence. Because if you don't, these subjects can begin to take on a mostly men in business suits sipping whiskey and puffing cigars in a smoke-filled room planning what's next type feel, right? And while I'm sure there's a breath of truth to that, it doesn't wholly correspond to the reality at hand. The rabbit hole is much deeper. Because when you listen to people who know these things, whose jobs it is to know, whether it's military folk or people who've been in the service or areas of research, PhDs, declassified stuff, when you listen to these people who know, and again, whose job it is to know, you begin to know, okay? But if we don't embrace the notion that there's more things going on than just the five cents level and nuts and bolts, then soon there's little choice left but to begin going in circles, because we've limited the scope of what's actually possible to a fraction of what it really is. It seems like these corrupt, morally bankrupt people have a low vibrational energetic compatibility with entities of akin qualities, okay? And these beings attach themselves to these people and become symbiotes, okay? And then these symbiotes have subtle, sometimes overt influence. Influences over their host, if you can imagine a soft possession type deal. All right, so when we elevate the corrupt, morally bankrupt people into power, we're also putting these apparently overwhelming demonic-like entities into power. So now you can sort of begin to see how we are pulling back the veil a bit on why it seems like these jokers are constantly engaging in activities to the destruction of the country and the people they claim to represent. All right, and it would seem that if there's not that symbiotic relationship I pointed out, then there's at least homage to these beings and rituals and blood sacrifice, okay? And there's hardly any bigger blood sacrifice than the often instigated and manufactured wars, or the wars that we started or got involved in based on false impetus, right? And this help alludes to the reason why we see the poisoning of our water, the genetic modification of our food, known harmful vaccine adjutants, spraying chemicals in the air, all that stuff, okay? Because you have to ask, if they're doing this, aren't they doing this to themselves? And the answer is, on one hand, they aren't really, because they live completely different lives from us. I mean, after all, when one of the Rothschilds came to buy some yacht in Texas, he brought his own food and water with him, okay? Now, on the other hand, I would argue that these people are being deceived by these beings, and that they're the ones being led down the primrose path. So in some instances, yeah, they are being impacted by this. And while I understand that there's a litany of schools of thought around these types of subjects, I think it's safe to say that there are areas of common understanding, namely that humans aren't the only factors to consider, and there seems to be a grand agenda perpetuated by low people in high places, and that there's a battle playing out right now, both physical and spiritual, and the result of that battle is going to have devastating consequences. Look, I'm just giving you guys milk right now. We're working our way up to solid food on subjects like this, all right? Take care of yourselves out there. California Carter, signing off.